lot of questions. I mean,
a lot. In the last 24 hours, we got over 100 questions. I can't make this video go on forever.
Or maybe I can.
That length of time. I mean, I could, but I feel like I'd bore you because, as you know, I get very passionate about answering each question. Moral of the story is we are going to be answering, I, Tiffany, am going to be answering your questions today. Enough of me talking. Let's just do this. Let's get into it. What was that? Oh, I'm on a new, I had way too much coffee today. Okay, I'm going to start answering some questions, and these are questions I asked for you to leave in my community tab here on YouTube. So it ranges from tech, career, coding, personal. You know me, I'm an open book. But how I'm going to answer these is I'm going to look at some of the top rated, meaning the most thumbs up questions, and kind of work my way from there. Question number one. I know there has, this is from Happy Happy. Happy Happy, I like your username. I know there have been a lot of layoffs in tech recently. Is this making it harder for self-taught programmers to land their first job? That is a great question, and I think it's something that's been on all of our minds, the amount of layoffs there has been in tech. And if you turn on the TV or go on the internet, it's no surprise that we all have this kind of fear in the back of our minds. As the great, it started with the great resignation earlier this year, everyone was quitting their jobs, and then it trickled into everyone was getting laid off of their job. So how does this affect people who are learning to code, or really even if you aren't a programmer, getting their first job, landing their first job in tech? And I think this is kind of a twofold, and as you know me, I'm a bit of an optimist, but let me explain why I think this doesn't have to be a bad thing or discourage you. Yes, there are a lot of layoffs happening, and that we'll pass through that, and we'll get back to the hiring cycle and demand for programmers. I mean, there is still a very high demand for programmers. But what I think will happen is if you are someone who is job hunting, you can feel more reassured that if this company is hiring, and hiring at quite great lengths, hiring a lot of people, they're definitely not going to be laying off their employees right away. They're not hiring and then on the backside of things, laying off employees. I mean, never say never. I'm not saying this is a perfect kind of way of looking at things, but that's a great way that I look at it. The company is really actively hiring and growing. Most likely you are pretty safe to interview with them, and if you decide to go with that company. So to answer your question, it really shouldn't impact you at all. I will continue to learn. You are learning a skill that is so in demand and will continue to.
Okay, question number two. Does the tech bootcamp you attend affect your employment? And honestly, the quick answer to that is, yeah, it really does. And that doesn't mean, though, if you went to a bootcamp that maybe wasn't that great or isn't really helping you out with employment now, that you can't find a job or you're totally screwed. Not by any means. But if you are considering going to a coding bootcamp, it really does. Coding or any kind of tech, whether it be UI, UX, design, etc. It does matter what bootcamp you go to. How come? Because the support they will offer afterwards and their reputation will really affect you in your job search. And this isn't to say that if you end up going to a bootcamp that isn't, you know, ideal, and you discover it as you are in the process of a coding bootcamp, that you can't get a great job, because it comes down to you as a person. But getting your foot in the door at that first company after the coding bootcamp or tech bootcamp, it does matter what coding bootcamp you went to. And I just want to elaborate a little bit more on that. I'm not trying to scare you by saying you need to go to this grandiose, expensive boot camp, because you definitely can go to, whether it's self-teaching or a coding boot camp, and get a great job and land a great job. At the end of the day, it really comes down to you as a person and your willingness to keep on moving forward. Because job hunting, when you're looking for your first job in tech, it's hard. It's really difficult. Once you get your foot in the door, that's a different story. But the initial getting your foot in the door, it's tough. Let's be honest here. And I don't want to discourage you if you do go to a coding bootcamp or any kind of tech bootcamp that you're like, oh, I wish I would have gone to a different one. You can still get a great job. But I'm just saying, if you are looking to go to a coding bootcamp, or I keep on saying coding then tech bootcamp, but for any kind of bootcamp, definitely take into consideration what support they have for after you graduate. For example, I went to a bootcamp many, many years ago, and they did not have any support after I graduated. It was literally like, shake your hand, say bye, and you're good luck. And it was a very difficult process to do on my own, and I would not recommend it for anyone.
Okay, another question I got asked from Betty Boop. I love Betty Boop, great name. What is the hardest thing you've had to face when learning to code? how do you continue to be motivated to learn? This is a great question. And I think the initial answer, or the answer some people might think that I would say, is, well, learning, you know, the basic fundamentals of JavaScript or Python, or maybe learning SQL and about databases is the hardest thing. It actually, the hardest thing about coding for me when I was learning how to code wasn't actually the code itself. Oh man, did I forget to turn off my phone? Wasn't actually the code itself, but rather the mental block that comes with learning how to code. And what I mean by that is, it's very easy when you start learning how to code to go online and there are these, it's what feels like this infinite number of resources to learn from. So-and-so is telling you to learn this, another person is telling you to learn this. Where do you actually begin? And it's so overwhelming. Alongside that, tech is moving so quickly, so it can often feel like you will never catch up. That's how I felt anyways. So, to answer your question, the hardest thing about learning to code that I faced was the mental blocks that I put on myself, the self-doubt, the self-worth. Am I good enough? Am I smart enough for this? And it took a while for me to step back and realize that I wasn't being kind to myself. I wasn't speaking to myself as I would speak to others. I was being really harsh to myself while going through the process of learning to code. My biggest advice for anyone who is learning to code is to be kind to yourself. If you're having a day where you are frustrated or stuck, take a step back. You don't need to keep on pushing forward sometimes if you feel like you've just don't have the energy. And another thing alongside that, if you can find a community or a mentor to support you, I mean, that's the whole reason I started tiffintech, was to support others in their journey. But if you need more of a one-on-one, finding that mentorship, but really recognizing that sometimes we are our biggest blocks in learning something new. And then when you kind of look at it from that point of view, it really helps excel things. Where did I graduate from and what course? So I went to university for graphic communications management at Ryerson University here in Toronto. And honestly, the course itself was 4 years long and it was a little bit of everything. So it was a bit of graphic design, a bit of communication, a bit of management. And it was in my last year, and I'm sure a ton of you have heard the story before, but it was in my last year that it was required to take a very basic coding course. From there, I ended up going to a coding boot camp. I went to BrainStation. And I don't actively share where I went to a coding boot camp because I went so many years ago that I really don't know what it is like now. So I'm not going to sit here and suggest something that I am not familiar with. And that's why I kind of always am reluctant to share with you what coding boot camp I went to. But I did have a great experience at the time.
Is age a barrier to learn web development? And I'm going to speak to this broadly, not just web development, but tech in general. No, there is no barrier as far as if you are too old, if you can break into tech or learn something new. I think one of the great things about tech is it's evolving so quickly, which means you need people who are willing to continually learn and grow. So don't put a limit on yourself based on your age. Of course, it's important to recognize as you get older, as we get older, different obstacles come in our way. So I'm not saying it's necessarily easy as you get older, but it's definitely possible and there is definitely space for you in this industry.
What are my music tastes? Oh, this is like the most difficult question, to be honest, because if you just looked on my Spotify or my Sonos, I do Sonos a lot so I can listen throughout the house in different rooms, but it's honestly mostly just jazz. I don't listen to a ton of music, which is really weird, and I feel really weird saying, because what does that say about me as a person? But honestly, it's when I'm working, I search in Spotify different kind of playlists around jazz. Otherwise, I don't really listen to music unless we're out or whatever, and that's just kind of whatever music is playing. So Paul, I listen to a lot of music that Paul, my boyfriend, listens to, whether it be rap. We're really actually into like electric music recently. I've been listening to a lot of old school, well, not too old, but like MGMT. That kind of stuff? I don't know. That's a really great question, but it's probably the hardest question on here. But curious to know, what is your favorite kind of music? Leave in the comments and let's see how many similarities we have. What is better at the beginning of your career, freelancing or working at a company? Oh, this is a great question. And one I had when I started out. I think it really depends on your personality. For me, I was someone who I knew I needed some more direction at the beginning of my career, some mentorship, a lot of mentorship. And I wasn't ready to take on working alone
finding clients on my own and not having that sense of mentorship. That being said though, you can find mentorship if you are freelancing. You just need to actively seek it out. So I think it really depends on what kind of personality you are. Are you someone who's comfortable from right out the get-go being able to just not know really what's coming up? You know, you're completely new to the industry, you're finding clients. Or, you know, if you are someone who maybe wants a bit more stability at the beginning of your career, starting out at a company is a great way to go. Honestly, I would gear more towards starting out at a company, but once again, there's always the exception to the rule. Well, this isn't really a rule, but really starting at a company will build up your network, will build up your skills so that you can start freelancing on the side and then eventually go freelance full time. Okay, those are, I mean, it was just 7 questions that I answered out of 100. I would answer more, but I know I'd be here all day. I try and answer less questions, but more in depth for you. That being said, if you have questions or if I didn't answer the question you have, leave it down below in the comments and I will make sure to answer all of your questions down below in the comments. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button and I will see you all soon. Thanks everyone.